just a very quick video as requested by a few of our members and followers in regards to the GBP Aussie dollar trade that we placed last night. There's a couple of reasons why we've taken this trade, hoping that it's a high probability trade for a slight reversal and turnaround up to the 1.8 region. In regards to the analysis behind this trade, what we're seeing, obviously, first of all, as you can see on the weekly time frame, is we are in a current upwards trend, okay, a current bullish trend, and this is indicated by the consistent higher highs and higher lows on this market, okay? So this is what I do first of all. I start breaking down the time frames, looking at monthly, weekly, daily, 4-hourly, and then entries on the hourly or the 15-minute time frames. So as you can see, obviously, we're in this bullish move at the minute. And we've consistently been in this bullish move since the beginning of the year, probably the end of the previous year, end of 2017. And where we are now, we're at a crucial point. Okay, so where I've highlighted here in yellow is a Fibonacci level, which obviously we'll go ahead to teach you in the course, actually how to put this into practice and how to use it and when to use it. But it indicates the fact that we should have a reversal, a potential short-term reversal happening on this market. So that's the weekly breakdown. Obviously, in terms of the EMAs that we use, again, we teach you the periods to use in the course, but as you can see at the moment, we are sort of just above our EMA, our blue EMA here on the weekly chart. So it's normally a potential area for a good reverse, a good turnaround in price, okay? And obviously then as we jump into the other time frames, okay, as we start looking at perhaps the daily time frame, what you'll see here is the automatic rejection from yesterday's candle, which is where we picked the market up. So we were actually looking at this around 7850, and we had a very quick 50 pip movement actually before we entered the market, which was quite frustrating, but obviously is showing that the area that we plotted out is you know, what we call a demand zone, okay? So an area whereby there are buyers entering the market at this point, okay? And we can see this quite clearly in this area here where we have a big bearish candle followed by a very big bullish engulfing candle. So it indicates that we've got buyers at this point, which is the reason for going ahead with this trade. And also, again, on this daily, we are looking at the EMA, okay? So we are rejecting that EMA. And personally, I think we've had quite a downtrend on on GBP, okay, over the last couple of weeks or so. And therefore, I think we need a bit of a correction on this market, a bit of a breather, and hence doing it, making the decision and taking a long trade on this market. Now, obviously, as we break this down on the 4-hourly time frame, okay, what you'll see on this 4-hourly time frame is a little bit more information in terms of the ranges, okay, that we've drawn on, which again we will teach you in the course how to do. And as you can see, the price has fallen right into this green and yellow area here, which is our Fibonacci retracement and our demand zone, okay? And we know this is a demand zone because we have seen it previously, okay, and there's a lot more synchronization further back in the charts. So we're potentially expecting a push out of our main indicator here, okay, out of these EMAs and up to the 1.8 region. And fingers crossed we make that today. This market is quite a quick moving market. And obviously the price we've entered is is a very good price. We're very low currently. And we certainly expect a reversal on this market, at least up to that 1.8 level. So hope that helps. Obviously pop some comments in the, I'm going to pop this video on YouTube, so put the comments in there if you can like it, share it. And obviously if you haven't already, just subscribe to our YouTube page as well. Thanks for listening.